Well, hello everyone, what is going on? It is the Almighty Geoff, and I'm here with episode 11 of Red Dead Redemption. In the previous episode, we captured another three bounties. We went to Solomon's Folly, where we got a scrap, and we stopped the Waltons gang from stealing a safe. And we finished off by taking Seth to Tumbleweed, which I got gold on in the mission A Gentle Drive with Friends. I got the fastest time, which was, it was relatively easy. I think one of the more difficult ones is shot accuracy. If you think that you may have possibly missed a bullet, then immediately stop and, as evil as it sounds, shoot the horses in front of you that are driving the carriage, which will force you to restart at a checkpoint, and then you can try again so you're absolutely certain that you've shot everybody. You've never missed a bullet, and then you should be able to get that one. Obviously, I do have a lot of things to tell you, including the reason why I've been away for a little bit of time. But I think that's a good time to explain it whilst I'm doing the bounty targets that we're going to do this episode. So we're just going to put this first one up. Let's have a quick mooch at who this may be. Who is it? Sink Bradshaw. Hanging Rock. Alright. That's not too far away. Let's go take him on then. So, I've not been active on the channel for roughly, I think, 2 or 3 weeks. And I'll... shut up, bounty... not bounty, jewel guy. Well, the week started off, I mean, I was fairly active during the summer holidays. And those last couple of days I was out in Manchester. So... oh, I should probably switch to a better weapon. See, like I said, I was in Manchester for quite a lot of time. Oh, I shot a... oh no, I don't want to shoot the horse. So yeah, those first 2 days I was in Manchester, and after that I ended up back in college. I'm trying to shoot a helmet off. Never mind. Right. Yeah, so I ended up back in college, and that, as well as working, is quite... takes a lot of energy out, so I don't usually upload videos or record videos on Mondays and Thursdays, because that's when I've got both college and work. So yeah, it's pretty exhausting. The Friday, I was preparing for my 18th, which was the day after, so I had to do a lot of clearing the house. Saturday I was working, and then it was my birthday party. Okay, are you coming? Are you coming or not? Come on, dude. Oh, sorry, horse. Whoa. Whoa. Hang on. Challenges. Must have already done that one. Never mind. I think we might have already done that one. That's just involving shooting the hats off of two enemies. I didn't know that we actually had that one. So there you go. Hey, dude, what are you doing? Boom, boom. Whoa! What the hell just happened? I totally shot you then, and then you just respawned. What was all that about? Right, I'm taking him back. So Saturday was my birthday. Sunday I was at a christening. I also had to deal with the house that was in a complete state. Then again, it was another week of college. And after that, I could have started uploading again, but I think on the Monday I did try and record, but storm hit in the middle of recording my Red Dead thing, and actually got a sudden power cut. which was obviously very infuriating. which completely knocked out all my electrics for like a split second. Bloody hell, $240, very nice. I'll carry on telling you what was going on at our second bounty. Right guys, so it's time for our second bounty target, which is Stanley Mund. He's at Mercer Station. A little bit further of a distance, just means I can cover more of my story really. Right, okay, Mercer Station. So yeah, so sudden power cut. Knocked out my electrics. I actually only really managed to get through the three bounties at the start of the episode, so I wasn't really, I didn't really lose that much progress. You know, still pretty annoying. My video actually was fine when it came through, it just obviously made a sudden cut. But my webcam video was non-existent. It was just said it was a corrupted file, so I knew I had to do it again anyway. So then, after that, because it had recently been my birthday and I got quite a bit of money in my account, I decided to upgrade my recording software. So I'm now using the Harpog HD PVR 2. Oh dear. Watch out, dear. Oh dear. Haha, puns. Whoa. Yeah, that. Somebody died. Whoa. Chill out, guys. Don't get on my bad side, Stanley. I don't want to have to shoot you. I don't want to lose profit. Whoa. Boom, bitch. You, sir. Sorry, Harsey. Yeah, going anywhere. How you ain't going anywhere. You coming with me, boy. You just should be glad that that train's already come by, dude. Otherwise, you'd be messed up right now. Philip, where have you gone? Why are you all the way down there? What did I tell you to go down there? I don't think I did. Get back over here, stupid horse. Right, so I got the Harpog thing. Appeared to be working, well, I'd set it up fine. There was no problems with, like, I was getting an image on my TV and my screen, so that was working. But it kept crashing the recording software. It's no longer using Arxiv Showbiz like it was with my first one. I'm now using Harpog Capture, and it kept crashing every two minutes, regardless of if I was recording or not. I had no idea how to fix it. I didn't know what I was doing wrong. I'd done a lot of research, couldn't think of anything. So I actually ended up having to email the tech department at Harpog. It took them about a week to actually respond to my email. But they got back in touch with me yesterday. And since then, I've been able to sort it out. In case anyone else having the same issue, check your video card. Sometimes it installs, I think it's called Plays TV. If you've got that on your system, then uninstall it, because it interferes with the thing and it caused it to crash. But it's working all fine now, so that's good. So that's why it's been so long since I've recorded. But now with this software, I can actually record my PlayStation 4 when the time comes, which should be very soon. And by very soon, I mean following Amnesia. I will probably be starting up the remastered playthrough of Heavy Rain. So I should hopefully manage to do a decent job of it this time. Because if you watched it on my original channel, you'd see what an absolute piece of crap that series was. But yeah. Anyway, I shall see you at my third target. So here's our third bounty target. Cooper Reed at the Hanging Rock. I've already been there, but it's close by, so I'm not arguing. So, over that period of time when I was trying to fix my recording, I did actually pick up quite a few games off my PS4. I finished off my Uncharted collection, although I've not started up Uncharted 4 yet. I got Until Dawn, which I finished within 2 days, platinum included, which was really an amazing game. I loved Until Dawn. It was like Heavy Rain, but horror version. As in, like, choices matter, multiple endings, stuff like that. So yeah, I definitely recommend getting that game if you haven't got it. Obviously I got Heavy Rain remastered, as well as Beyond Two Souls remastered, which I've never played before. And the final thing that I got was Black Flag, Assassin's Creed 4. I got that remastered for the PS4, so in like quite a long while. It's going to be a while before I play Black Flag, because it's like miles off. That'll be in its best quality, hopefully. Looks like the PS5's out by then, and then it's been remastered for that. Should doubt it will be. But there's been obviously some big news for the Assassin's Creed fan base, as the Ezio trilogy is being remastered for the PS4, and that's coming out in mid-November, I think. So, in the chance that I may finish Assassin's Creed 1 before Assassin's Creed 2 gets remastered, I may fit a game in between the two, because I always want to play my games in the best quality that it can be. That's why I'm not playing GTA 5 at the moment. I'm going to play that soon. I was waiting until I had the ability to record my PS4 to do that, but I do already have 4 series going on. I don't really want to overload myself. $106, not too bad. I've actually got quite a bit of money. So we're going to go ahead and run the next mission for Seth. The last mission for Seth, actually. Just all the way in Tumbleweed. Obviously, if you started that up immediately after the second mission, you'd already be over there. So if you're following the schedule I used to do in my old channel, where I just did those two missions back to back, it's not really that much of a difference. But I shall see when we reach Tumbleweed. Okie dokie, guys, I've just arrived in Tumbleweed. We are about to start up the final mission in the Seth branch, which is Let the Dead Bury the Dead.
Oh, it's like that, is it? Huh? Not talking to Seth today? Oh, the old silent treatment. Oh, whoa, woohoo! That's quite a stint.
Hey, Seth! Seth, come back here.
Oh, hey, partner. I was just looking for you.
Looking for me? What? Over there?
How you doing?
I'm good.
Well, see you later, partner.
Where you going, partner?
Nowhere.
Okay. Nowhere wouldn't happen to be where that thing you're looking for is kept, would it?
No, sir. No, sir.
Come on, partner.
Okay, I was just fooling. Partner, you know, the thought of that treasure does funny things to me. According to the map, it's somewhere in that big abandoned house.
Well, that can't be at all suspicious now, can it? We've had multiple dealings here in Tumbleweed already. Let's just hope, by which I mean I already know what's going to go down, that we're not going to encounter any resistance, but we totally are. Spoiler alert. Hey, what'd I say? Right, okay, just checking out the quick gun out. Remember, headshots and accuracy, that's what I'm always aiming to go for. Oh, I don't think so. During this mission, we are also going to grab a piece of treasure for the treasure hunter challenge, as it is on the way. Don't think you are going anywhere, Sunny Jim. Hey, you diving behind cover? I don't think that's gonna save your life, sir. Boom. Oh no, don't wanna shoot the gun. That ain't good. You'll penalize me for that, bro. Well, two bullets? I don't believe I ordered you to shoot twice. Alright, come on, Seth. Let's keep her going. Oh dear, front door's locked. Let's try around the back. So you wanna head into the basement? This is for the treasure. It's just along the way, so we might as well. Okay, alright. We should encounter some resistance. Yep, there we go. Hey, stop shooting twice. You were going to correct my accuracy. And then I'm not gonna like you very much, not at all. Can you stop running off, dude? What? No, the textures are glitching. What are you doing? Oh my days, man. You just ruined everything. What the hell is going on with the graphics? Where is the treasure? Where have you put my treasure? Stop glitching out screen, please. For the love of God, there it is. What the hell are you doing, dude? Jesus. Are you gonna shoot somebody? Can you fix my freaking graphics? What on earth is going on with the graphics? Explain that to me, please. You found nothing. I found the treasure. Right, can we go upstairs now? And can the screen not glitch out like an MFA? It doesn't like being so weird, it doesn't appear. Oh my god, it is still doing it. Why are you still being glitchy with me? Hey, John, you need to provide some assistance with me here, buddy. I think we will, dude. I think they've already found it, you know. Oh my god, you are ruining my accuracy. You didn't like that, did you? Whoa, dude. You're standing between me and the treasure.
I'm sure whoever that belonged to treasured it very much.
Stupid liars. Those stupid chicken shit maps. Making a damn fool of me. A glass eye. It's a glass eye.
Stop with the tears and help me with Williamson's gang. And you can come up with another excuse to go exhume one of your old friends.
Hunting dead man's treasure ain't done me no favors. Sure. Sure. I'm ready for the living. I'll see you and Mr. West Dickens over at Fort Mercer when you gentlemen is ready.
$10 frickin'. Whoop de frickin' do. Wow, we got quite a bit of fame for that. Can we... Thank you. Right, how did we do there? Not too shabby. I'm not really happy with that accuracy though. Right, so how long are we sitting at the moment? 24 minutes. Should be short for you guys. Should I do it? Should I do it? I think we should. I'm gonna go ahead and fire up the next mission at Ridgewood Farm. Because it'd be a bit of an empty episode if I only did a mission and some bounties. So I'm gonna try and fit in something else. So yes, I am playing with a new recording device. I'm going to be doing Heavy Rain after finishing Amnesia. Then I shall be playing most likely Until Dawn. I think. I don't think that'll be a long series though. I might just do a episode, well, a chapter per episode, and there are 10 chapters in the game. And then possibly do one on the bad endings. Oh crap. I don't know. Actually, no, I might split up the bad endings and do them actually as a whole thing. But here's Lies, Cheats, and Other Pred Americans.
Mr. Marston, how are you, sir?
I'm all right. I met up with your friend, Seth.
Oh, Seth of the Dead. Yes, interesting fellow. You don't meet many men these days with the moral fortitude to cut straight to the chase like that, do you?
Thankfully not, Mr. West Dickens.
Yes, contemporary society is remarkably harsh on professional exhumers. But did you know that in ancient Egypt, it was an art form valued more highly than literature? I believe Seth comes from that school of thought.
How very interesting. Look, you thought any more about our plan?
Ah, your plan, dear boy, your plan. I am merely the help, not mercifully the arbiter of wisdom.
What you are, dear boy, is the man whose life I've saved twice now. A man who sells lies and deceit to unwitting people. A man who, if he doesn't help me, I won't think twice about putting a bullet through his skull, feeding to the vultures myself.
You see, Mr. Marston, you have the exterior of a violent man, but the soul of an angel, and that is what I think I cherish most about you.
That's what I thought.
But before we can attend to your particular problems, we need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business, and this being America, that lubricant with which we concern ourselves is money.
Money? What are you talking about?
Oh, we need weapons. Armor plate for the wagon, extra hands, and I need some danger money.
So, let's sell some more of these cures.
Sell cures? Around here? Do you want to see me lynched? No. The sport of kings. Racing, my friend. The sport of kings. A noble activity without reproach. Exactly the kind of activity where a lying, cheating, degenerate like myself can prosper. But come. Let's finish the loading and we'll discuss it as we drive. Now, sir, two yak, two breach.
Okie dokie. I don't know if he's going to talk on the way there.
Seth is an interesting fellow, is he not?
I wouldn't say interesting, more deeply disturbed. I can see why you two get along.
I see the good in everybody, John. It's a flaw of mine. I have a soft spot for life's flotsam and jetsam.
Connection with them, more like. You and Seth have a lot in common. You both rob people, for one. My
mind you, at least he waits until they're dead.
Ah, my dear boy. Nobody is more critical of drinkers than a drunk who's mended his ways.
What are you talking about?
Come on now, John. I've heard about you. You spent your life robbing people. It's a little inappropriate to be taking the moral high ground now.
I had the courtesy to put a gun in their face.
Whatever helps you sleep easily at night.
We stole from those who had too much. Tried to give to those who had too little.
A Robin Hood with spurs. Oh, romantic. You expect me to believe that, poppycock? Maybe I'll have the good fortune to be able to leave my nefarious life behind one day and work on the government's dime.
Don't talk about things you don't understand.
Dear, oh dear, simmer down, my boy. You need to start appreciating your friends more. Folks around here don't see you as any different from Bill Williamson.
I didn't think I'd have to huckster snake oil and dig up the dead, that's all.
Take it from me, John. Collaboration is the key to success. I can help you. Seth can help you. It's business. Nothing more, nothing less. There's no need to make it quite so personal.
Suits me.
How far away are we now? Jesus. Is he gonna keep talking or can I skip? Okay, 5 more seconds, dude. Right, I'm skipping. Oof. Right. How long am I sitting at? 31 minutes. Damn. Might be a bit of a long one. Okay. Come on, dude. Hurry the frick up. Yes, we are at Gap Tooth Breach. Alright, here we go. Onto the cart.
Grabbers! Y'all know the rules! But for you newcomers, this here's a fair race! Keep to your manners and let the faster cart pass! So now that's been said, y'all can get to running each other off the road like always!
As you can probably assume, the goal of this is to win. So it's sort of similar to Obstacles in Our Path, which is the third mission we did in this game. Except obviously this time you're in a cart. And really the only similarity is the fact that we're racing. And it's not really that difficult a thing. The only requirement in this one is the time. Oh, don't shoot people. That's not a good idea. They might get a bit salty about that. Yeah, one requirement is the time, which is not too difficult if you skip cutscenes and you do relatively well in the race. So there's nothing really difficult about this mission. The most likely cause of failure is the cart flipping. So you just got to be careful about taking corners. That, there's nothing really one can say. So yeah, so what I was saying before about Until Dawn, maybe because I mean when I do Heavy Rain, because there are so many chapters, when I come to doing the bad endings for the trophies, I'm just going to do like quick cuts to show you the different choices you have to make, like I did in my original channel. But with Until Dawn, the story, because I mean it's just such an interesting story that can take so many twists, I might just restart from the latest opportunity to start the bad ending. So I think that was episode 6 out of 10, and then make my way through the game again, but just taking the bad options. Obviously I'm not going to give anything away about that. Quite a lot of people probably haven't played it, which you really should, because it is quite scary in your first time. Not amnesia scary, I don't think, but jump scares and stuff, and there's some quite sudden ones, it's quite can be quite disturbing as well, a few of the scenes. But it's good to see how it plays out the first time for you, how your decisions impact on the endings of all the characters and who survives and stuff. So if you haven't played it yet, and you can, I definitely recommend that you do before watching me do it, but other than that, it's up to you, really. But yeah, easy win. No problemo.
Race, mister. I'll take care of this cart for Mr. West Dickens.
Come on, John. I suggest we beat a hasty retreat.
Oh, you've gone on that side, I guess. Alright. Come on, Dickens.
Right. Best remove ourselves from the stage before somebody decides they want their money back.
Fine by me.
Isn't that fantastic? The cheers of the crowd, the thunder of the wheels.
Falling rocks. Homicidal maniac.
Oh, come on, John. Even a cold-hearted misanthrope like you must have found that just the tiniest bit exhilarating.
Not the friendliest bunch, are they?
They take the racing very seriously in these parts, and your participation was not entirely pre-approved.
That was clear.
Ah, sport, war, and heartache. The guilty pleasures of mankind since the dawn of time.
Get away from the men we just swindled before you start waxing too lyrical.
Yes, yes, of course.
I guess we're kind of stuck in this now. So don't seem to be able to skip. Dude, oh, I think we're done.
Well done, sir. Well done. Having you as a ringer has netted us a fine profit.
We seem to be wasting time, old man.
Oh, patience, my friend. The Trojan horse cannot run before it can walk, if you'll forgive the metaphor. Next, we need to procure some grand and overwhelming firepower. And for that, you need to contact an old friend of mine. Goes by the name of Irish.
Irish.
Yes, he's an interesting kind of fellow. He usually can be found in Armadillo or some other town around here on some Bacchanalian revel or such.
Great. An alcoholic arms dealer.
What could be better?
And the $3. Okay. Fair enough. 200 fame. I'm not arguing with that. Have a look at our stats. Probably going to be bronze. Yeah. Like I said, skip cutscenes and do relatively well, and that shouldn't be a problem. So we'll just have a look at our map. We have the next Nigel West Dickens mission, which is kind of swindler changes spots down here. We have the first mission for Irish, which is a Frenchman, a Welshman, an Irishman up in Armadillo, and then we've still got the burning up at McFarlane's Ranch. So obviously you can go ahead and do whichever one of those you want. I think the order we'll do it is probably we'll do finish off Dickens, then we'll do Irish, then Bonnie. But other than that, I think we've made enough progress this episode, by which I mean we've reached that point where I don't really want to go over the limit, because I know a lot of people don't really want to watch long videos. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye, guys.